3 coplanar points.
Bam! Water levels give you horizontal.
There's the radius of the Earth.
On the level.
The way I phrase it is a monument to the curvature of the Earth. It really is.
Level.
Bam! Water levels give you horizontal.
There's the radius of the Earth.
Fight the flat Earth.
Fucking up the flat Earth.
Fight the flat Earth.
Destroy the flat Earth.
The flat Earth.
Kill them. Annihilate the flat Earth.
Fucking up the flat Earth.
Exterminate all flat Earthers.
Fucking up the flat Earth.
Got a couple of super chats. One from Rob Keane. Level is horizontal. Oh, that's cool. Message has been deleted. Thanks, Rob Keane.
Listen to my words very carefully. Definitions are meaningless.
I have done personal calculations in the military, well, for fuel consumption, that only work when we're on a sphere.
The surface is not curved, you twat.
Yep, it's still a sphere, though, isn't it?
Once the mind clicks in the fact that, like, these observations I'm making are impossible on a flat Earth, there has to be bendy water. You know, there just has to be. You know, I can accept when I don't know things, and I do not know that. Do you know what I mean? I don't know what you're talking about enough to be able to actually discuss it with you. I didn't need to do any experiments. You know, I just looked at photos.
Ah, piss off!
In non-Euclidean geometry, straight lines can curve. Because straight lines can be curved. Well, there we go then. In a mathematical sense, a straight line can be curved. Clearly that the Earth is curved. For fucking up the flat Earth.
Mic check.
Yeah.
You're okay.
Man, I was just gonna go to bed, man.
Yeah, you better go to bed. I just say, yeah, I'm gonna talk to you soon. I haven't forgotten about you.
Sweet.
Like, yeah.
What's the wait?
I hope everything is okay. All is good, you know. Wish you all the best in the future.
yeah
because you're gonna need it. You're gonna need a lot of luck in the future.
Really?
Yep.
Sweet. So are you gonna come in and talk to Emma, or are you
I'm gonna have to talk to you guys separately, so I think I'll talk to you first, then I'll talk to Emma after that. One or the other.
Sweet. When can we, are we booking this or?
Oh no, we're not booking this. I just came to say that it's still on.
Right. So
not
now
then. It's gonna happen. I've just been a little bit busy.
Okay.
Not now. Obviously not right now. No.
All right. So do I need to practice anything? Do I need to get anything ready or? Like, what's the deal?
Mean, it's not a debate. We're just talking, right? We're talking about current events and what you guys, you know? Because now, what's going to happen now that you can no longer go on Ranty's channel because you're banned there? The only place you can go is Jose's.
No, Jose's banned us as well.
Oh, really?
Oh, yeah.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Well, I guess there's nowhere you can go now. But, I mean, I'm not trying to be an asshole or anything. I'm being... What are your goals? Do you want... are you trying to reach a larger audience? What are your goals in particular?
Why does it matter to you? What's the...
It doesn't. You're right. It doesn't.
Yes, wait.
But you'd think that you would know by now, though, right?
You'd think what? What would you think?
After 5 years, you'd have your...
5 years? What are you talking about?
Well, you probably haven't been in it as long as I have, I don't think.
Oh, you've done 5 years, have you? You've done your 5-year service.
Probably longer, I think. This is probably going to be...
So what? Oh, are you... The idea is that you're coming round to check up on... What? I don't know. What are you doing, Babs? I mean, what's the idea?
Well, you wanted me to talk to you, right? So I was going to come and talk to you.
Okay.
Unless there's something specific you want to talk about.
Well,
I brought a question of what I thought you might want to talk about, but you said that you were concerned about why I was concerned about that. Like, why did I want to
initially
know about that, right?
Initially, we had a... I don't know, you said it wanted a debate, but then... It left everyone wondering what the fuck it was that you were after and what the debate was about.
Really?
Yeah. And then, like...
Who's everybody?
Everybody. Like literally everybody.
Yeah, who is that? Is everybody?
Everybody I talked to. And everybody that heard that, whatever it was that happened at Jose's.
So basically, the entire On The Level crew that are never going to disagree with you or go against you.
Yeah,
that's everybody you're talking about, right?
Nobody knows what the fuck it was that you were doing. I said level is horizontal, and you said what?
Uh-huh.
You said that it was perpendicular.
I said that level... Yeah, I said that level is perpendicular to the force of gravity.
Right, well...
How is that not...
Gravity, according to you, is what a plumb bob does, which is vertical. And perpendicular means at 90 degrees. So 90 degrees to vertical is horizontal. So level... is horizontal. You basically said exactly the same thing, just in a different way.
But it's not.
But you added gravity in, which was brilliant. I like a genius baller move.
Yeah, because you need gravity.
Yeah, you need gravity.
No way you can determine. There's no way you can determine level without the force of gravity. All of those tools you're talking about, like plumb bobs or water levels, they all work.
Using the force of gravity.
Now, literally, it's not a force.
Force.
Yeah. If you didn't have that, you would not be able to use those tools.
Okay.
It
so
just wouldn't work.
You're going along with gravity being a force. Right?
Correct.
Now, literally, it's not a force.
Okay.
And there's no reason why gravity is exclusive to the
Goldberg
model.
You are a baller then, right? Like,
oh, here we go. You know, there's no reason gravity should be exclusive to the globe Earth model.
So the thing about Newton's laws, you can't take it literally, but Newton himself didn't. Newton had various ideas on this, but generally it's thought that Newton did not take his own law that literally.
Well,
and the fact that you
I'm
people,
saying like the globe Earth the model, right? George Musa said to Craig, Fight the Flat Earth, that gravity is not a force.
Now, literally, it's not a force.
Right? But now, here's
you know,
saying that it is a force, which is exactly what Fight the Flat Earth says. Right? Now, out of everyone, would you say you stand on the side of Fight the Flat Earth or George Musa?
Now, literally, it's not a force.
Because at the minute, when you're saying gravity is a force, you are on the side of Fight the Flat Earth and not on the side of George Musa. So exactly who are you backing with saying gravity? Because I just say vertical, plumb.
I'm not on anybody's side. I'm just stating what has been proven time again with science. So it doesn't matter what Craig or George Musa have to say, because this has always been a fact even before they exist.
So the thing about Newton's laws, you can't take it literally, but Newton himself didn't. Newton had various ideas on this, but generally it's thought that Newton did not take his own law that literally.
And the only reason you think that gravity is not a force...
Literally, it's not a force.
...is because of Anthony Reilly. He's the one who started that nonsense.
Dude, I don't need gravity at all.
Literally, it's not a force.
Of course you do.
No, I don't.
You wouldn't be able to use those plumb bobs or those water levels if you didn't have gravity.
Literally, it's not a force.
So tell me this though: how would plumb bob goes down,
right?
Why does it go
down? It's vertical.
No, but why does the plumb bob go down?
Why did you ask that question?
Why did I ask that question?
Yeah, why did you ask that question?
Because I wanted an answer from you. Why does a plumb bob go down?
Because that's vertical. It is the tool that establishes a vertical.
No, it goes down because of the force of gravity.
Literally, it's not a force.
And you can deny that as much as you want to. And like I said, the only reason you're doing that is because of Anthony Reilly.
I'm not denying that a plumb bob goes vertical, right? I'm not denying that because it is a tool for establishing a vertical. Right?
Yeah, and that tool wouldn't work if gravity was not a force.
Literally, it's not a force.
Well, look, it works and it establishes a vertical. Doesn't it? And perpendicular to that vertical is horizontal, which you said perpendicular to the vertical is level. So therefore, horizontal perpendicular to vertical is level. Level is horizontal. Exactly what I've been saying.
But how did you get to that point to begin with?
Geometry.
You didn't start with a horizontal
geometry
line, did you? No, you didn't.
Yeah, I did.
Okay, tell me how you got to that point then. Because you want to act as though you didn't have to use a plumb bob or water level to get that horizontal line.
A water level.
And yeah, doesn't a water level establish vertical? Vertical.
No,
like you say, right?
No, a water level establishes a horizontal level. Plane of reference.
It establishes level, right. But level is perpendicular to the force of gravity.
Literally, it's not a force.
Yeah, vertical, right? A plumb bob is a tool, a device that establishes a vertical. That perpendicular to vertical is horizontal. And I'll say it again. You say... level is perpendicular to vertical, which is horizontal. Level is horizontal. But pretty simple.
No, because that's just one axis. Horizontal is one axis.
Yeah, and vertical is the other axis.
Exactly, so it's perpendicular to the force of gravity.
The plumb bob is the tool that establishes a vertical.
Right.
Right.
It establishes level. You keep trying to
no, a plumb bob. Vertical.
It establishes level, not vertical. And level.
No, I'll say it again, Babs. I mean, you seem really, really you're struggling, right? Maybe all of the Messiah complex.
Now you listen here. It's not the Messiah. It's a very naughty boy.
Has gone to your head, but. A plumb bob establishes a vertical, right? That is not level. That is plumb. It's at 90 degrees to level. Right. Perpendicular 90, to 90 it.
With what? The plumb bob is 90 degrees with reference to what?
Sorry, what do you mean? 90 degrees with reference to what?
Yeah.
Perpendicular to the vertical is horizontal.
Right.
Yeah.
And that's perpendicular to the downward vector, which is gravity.
A horizontal is a completely different frame of reference than a vertical. A plumb bob is a tool for establishing a vertical frame of reference, and a level is a tool for establishing a horizontal frame of reference. Now, these are two separate tools.
Okay. So if a level was a tool for establishing a vertical?
No.
No, not a vertical, my bad. A horizontal frame of reference. When I put a bubble level on a pyramid or a pivot balance, why does it balance out? If that surface beneath it is not a horizontal line, why is it showing that the surface is level?
What are you talking about, dude?
You see, this is what the problem is.
No. The problem is you're not making yourself clear. What are you doing with a level, putting it on top of a pyramid? What are you doing? Have you ever worked with a level? Have you ever done anything with a tool?
Yeah, I have. Yeah, but it was a long time ago.
Okay, so in your experience of using the tool, a level, did you often put it on the top of pyramids to try and... What were you trying to do? Were you trying to level the top of the pyramid? Like when I'm thinking pyramid here now, just to make sure, it's that pointy thing, the right. Triangular pointy shape. Now, when you had the level, did you put the level on the pointy bit at the top?
Yeah.
Right. Now,
and it showed
what was
showed
the point?
At the top
what you tried to balance the level on top of that pointy bit on top of a pyramid, did you?
Yeah, and how...
Nice. For what purpose?
How is that still not level?
Well, for what purpose did you try and balance a level on the top of a pyramid, the pointy bit on the top of a pyramid?
Oh, I haven't done that yet.
Oh.
I know that it's possible because you can put a bubble level on a basketball and it would do the same thing.
Right, okay.
It would balance at the top.
Okay, so balancing a level on the top of an object, do you think that would make the, like, let's say the basketball, it's much easier. We're putting a level on top of a basketball, do you think that would level the basketball?
Define what you mean by level the basketball.
I'm just asking you, dude, because you said that that's what you did, right?
It would give you a point of reference on that basketball, a point which is perpendicular to the downward vector. That's what you get.
Perpendicular on the surface of a ball.
Yeah.
You're not very well versed in geometry, are you?
Well, why don't you explain it in a better way, since you're more versed?
Right. A level establishes a horizontal plane, and because a horizontal is a flat surface, straight, flat, two-dimensional surface.
Who said that?
Then
horizontal is a.
I agree. Level's horizontal.
Anyway, go ahead.
Go on. Who said? I just said a horizontal is a flat, two-dimensional plane surface.
And is level a flat two-dimensional plane?
Yes, level is a straight line on a horizontal plane. Yes.
Really?
Yes. What?
That's true.
Because
yeah,
it level... is perpendicular to vertical, right? Horizontal. And vertical being a straight line, then perpendicular is the relationship of two straight line to another straight line at 90 degrees opposed to it. Therefore, horizontal must be a straight line.
Yeah, horizontal is a straight line.
Yep.
But as far as what level is, it's the perpendicular between the vertical line and the horizontal line. And when you're saying that the flat surface is horizontal, that's true, yeah. It's like a horizontal line would be parallel with a perfectly flat surface.
A horizontal plane is a two-dimensional surface.
Horizontal plane or surface, yeah. A planar surface. But how have you determined that? How have you determined that the surface of the ground that we're on is planar? How do you know that?
Listen, Babs, stop before you carry on, right? Nobody has said the surface of the land we live on is a two-dimensional planar surface. No one has said that.
I didn't say that either.
Level is a straight line on a horizontal plane.
Is a flat surface two-dimensional?
Yes.
Really?
Yes. As is a plane surface.
It doesn't have length, width, and breadth. It doesn't have those axes.
Say that again.
Those are three different dimensions.
Say that again.
A flat surface, does it not have length, width, and it might not have height.
Yeah, it just has two of the dimensions.
Okay, I see what you're saying. It has two dimensions, yes. Right? But we don't live in a two-dimensional world.
Yeah, well done. Brilliant. So the Earth is not flat. Like I've said all along, the Earth is provably not
flat. Is it a globe then?
Flat.
Is it a globe then? What is it then?
Well,
it's not flat.
Surveyors, like I keep saying, Babs, like you seem to be siding with, I don't know who, right?
I'm not siding
surveyors,
with anyone.
Surveyors measure a change in elevation, right? In the vertical, like a vertical change in height is a change in elevation. Now, surveyors measure that change in the vertical and mark it as a change in elevation.
Yeah.
Right. So therefore, the vertical change is referenced to a perpendicular plane surface. So horizontal is level. Yes, elevation change.
In reference to mean sea level, what do you mean by elevation? Just so that we're on the same page.
Dude.
Is it in reference to
mean
sea level?
I'll do it again. Elevation. Elevation and a change in elevation is a change in the vertical. A measured height difference on the vertical, the z-axis, right, would be a change in elevation.
Yeah.
Right. Okay.
Along the vertical axis. But what is, I just want to know what your definition I don't know what your definition of elevation is. What is your definition of elevation?
Have I not just told you?
No, you didn't.
Right.
You just
elevation,
said it's a change in the vertical.
Yes. Well, that's it. I mean, what else is there?
Well, there's another definition.
What?
That you're ignoring completely.
Go on. You tell me. Like, because I don't know. I mean, I only know the surveying
the
term
is,
I don't want to get into those definitions
because you already think I'm a baller.
I already know, right? Because I've done surveying. I've been to college and done it. So with the surveying tools that establish a horizontal plane of reference, you measure a change in the vertical, right, with that tool. That's
right.
The very tool that you change it, right? Now,
why is it consistent?
What do you mean? Why is it consistent? Why is what? It's only consistent if there is no change. If there's a change, like there's a lump or a hill or anything like that, then there is a change in elevation. It's not consistent.
What I mean is, why is that change in elevation consistent? It is.
What are you talking
from
about?
Every point of observation, the drop is consistent.
The
it
drop of what?
The drop from vertical.
Of
that,
what?
That elevation change that you're referring of, it's consistent.
It's measured, right? It's a measured change.
You're the one that sounds like you're confused because you try to say that I was confused, but you're the one.
No, I'm not. Right? I'm not confused. I know how to measure a change in the vertical, right? To measure a change in elevation, I know how to do that. I've been to college and done it.
So why do you?
I've got an auto level. I've actually used these tools.
Distance. Right. Why do things consistently drop in the distance when we observe them?
What things constantly drop? I don't know what you're talking about, dude.
When you look at mountains.
Well, like a mountain rises in the distance. It doesn't drop in the distance.
No, it doesn't.
But it's how we know. A valley drops, right? A mountain rises. I don't know what you're talking about.
It drops vertically. And there's a reason for that.
The mountain rises vertically. That's why they have a different height, an elevation height.
Measuring this, the level surface drops down from the horizontal plane at a rate of 8 inches times the distance in miles squared. I did not say that the level is not horizontal. Oh yeah, it's measurable.
Wait, what's up with you?
I wish I had pictures of me right now, because you know exactly what I'm talking about and you're just pretending like you don't. And there's a reason for that. There's a reason why things drop in the distance. And it's not because we live on a ball.
Things don't drop in the distance unless they are at a lower elevation.
So why constantly at a lower elevation? Pardon? Why does everything we look at...
You keep breaking up, dude.
Why is everything that we look at dropping away from... Well, why is it dropping? Why is that elevation change happening?
If there's a mountain, if there's a mountain in front of you, then the elevation rises, doesn't it? It doesn't drop.
So things just consistently keep rising. Look at them.
A mountain does.
There's no horizon.
If there's something higher than you in front of you, it goes up. And if it's lower than you, it goes down. There's a change in the vertical height. Up is higher.
Below the horizon. Why does that happen? Why do things...
Dude.
Why does that happen?
Why do things what? Say that again.
You want to deny that that happened?
I don't know what you said. I asked you to repeat it, please. What?
How do you not know what I'm saying and I'm saying it right now?
How do I not know what you're saying when you're saying it right now? What the fuck does that mean, Babs?
Behind the horizon. Why does that happen?
Did you say behind the horizon?
Yeah.
Right, so the horizon, for you to say behind, right, that would put the horizon as a physical thing for something to go behind it. Now, I'll tell you right now, the horizon is an apparent position.
That doesn't mean that it's not physical.
It does to me. It says apparent. No, it's apparent.
This is all Nathan Oakley 101. You're just spewing Nathan Oakley's garbage, you know?
Are you obsessed with Nathan or something?
You're trying to pretend like this stuff really makes sense when it doesn't. We can see the horizon because it's actually there.
It's apparent.
An apparent position doesn't mean that it doesn't exist.
Well, where is it? Where is the horizon, Babs? Where is it?
Right in front of you.
Where?
It's right in front of you.
Where?
You wouldn't see it if it didn't exist.
Where?
You would not see it if it did not exist.
Where is it?
As far as the distance to the horizon,
you can't
measure
it. So it's an apparent position then. Now,
that doesn't mean that it's
how
not
can
real.
Anything go that behind mean that it's not it?
Real. That doesn't mean that it's not a real position.
Okay. Now, are you assuming, Babs, that the horizon is, let's say, a mountain? That there could be something behind.
No, I'm not assuming that, but I want to address the dumbass that's calling me dumber than rocks? You,
I'd,
yeah, do you have I'd the balls not to, bother to looking say that at to the, my face chat. Right now, dumbass?
I wouldn't bother looking at the chat, Babs. You get end up getting triggered by it.
Yeah, and, I'm not going to bother with it. Just, if you don't have the balls to talk shit to me face to face, then don't even bother doing it.
You're talking to me right now, Babs.
I'm just enjoying the show. Just continue, Barbara.
Yeah, you can do that one after, Babs. You're meant to keep focus. Focus. Come on.
And listen, we weren't even supposed to be doing this right now. You're going to bed. I came to tell you that we're going to do this later.
Oh, okay. So sweet. This is cool. Let's do it. Let's do it again.
This is not even. We were just supposed to talk about this in a cordial way, but it can be whatever you want it to be. You know, if you're really honest and you want to learn something,
on
then
the
you
level,
really
mate.
Listen to what I have to say. Because I'm listening to you, but you're not being honest. You're being dishonest. You're probably recording this right now. So,
yeah.
You know, I want to get to the level where we feel like we understand each other and we're not just doing this back and forth. Because I put a lot of work into our debate. And for you to say that you didn't understand what I was talking about is complete nonsense, dude. What? Like, seriously.
Dude, like, you're not seriously thinking that that was a debate, are you?
Well, whatever that was.
I don't know. I haven't got a clue.
You're pretending that people weren't in agreement with what I was saying, and that's nonsense. A lot of people agreed with me. All the ballers loved what you said. It's only your dick writers that disagreed with me. That's what really happened.
Yeah.
But yeah, we'll do this again soon.
Sweet.
Good night.
Do you not want to do it over on... we can't really do it anyway. Do you want to do it on Nips or...
I don't know who Nick is.
Nips.
Oh, Nips?
The nameless internet potatoes.
That's not what I'm not one of the tap dancers. I don't want detention or whatever. We're just talking like normal human beings.
You don't need to follow me. You don't need to follow anybody. You've got to think for yourself. You're all individuals.
So I don't want to be on YouTube or any of that bullshit.
No.
We're just having a normal conversation, which you're obviously recording right now because you always do that.
You don't want to speak to your subjects.
My subjects.
Yeah, yeah. You're the Messiah, aren't you?
Now you listen here. He's not the Messiah. He's a very naughty boy.
I don't need to address them. They do the same thing
the
over and over again.
The great flat earth messiah.
I come up.
Yes, we're all individuals. You're all different.
Yes, we are all different.
I'm not.
I come out with new material. They take my material. And yeah, you see it happening. It's undeniable. So.
You don't need to follow me. You don't need to follow anybody.
I mean, I don't need to say anything. I felt like I needed to, but you can see it for yourself, or you can be in denial. But yeah, you have a good night. I'll talk to you later.
Sweet. And yeah soon.
Good night, Barbara.
Like water. Now, you put water into a cup, it becomes the cup. You put water into a bottle, it becomes the bottle. You put in a teapot, it becomes the teapot. Now, water can flow, or it can crash. Be water, my friend. Be water, my friend. Now, you put water into a cup, you put water into a cup. It becomes the cup. You put water into a bottle, it becomes the bottle. You put in a teapot, it becomes the teapot. Now water can flow, water can flow. Or it can crash, or it can crash. Be water, like the water. Like water. Now you put water into a cup. It becomes the cup. You put water into a bottle, it becomes the bottle. You put in a teapot, it becomes the teapot. Now water can flow, or it can crash.
One another. Now, literally, it's not a force. So the thing about Newton's laws, you can't take it literally. But Newton himself didn't. That's what's or Newton had various ideas on this, but generally it's thought that Newton did not take his own law that literally, that there is a force reaching from one object out to another. However, you can act as if there were one, and it's perfectly valid for the applications of Newton's laws.